Hello, this is Rick Ridings coming to you from Sukkot Hillel 24/7 in Jerusalem with another prayer perspective that we things we feel the Lord is highlighting to us to pray here right now. It's day 78 of the war. It's a very important time not to give in to kind of an apathy and sleepiness, but to stay alert in the Spirit to what the Holy Spirit wants us to pray. And it's so important. We're so thankful for all of you that have come from the nations and that tune in together to pray and worship together with us, because we believe it's making a difference. And we're very blessed here in Jerusalem to see that the kind of October 7th kind of thing that they were predicting to happen from East Jerusalem has not happened by God's grace. And we do feel the prayer and worship going up is part of calming down what the demonic realm would like to do. Today I'd like to share with you something the Lord reminded me of. In the past week, the IDF two times came very, very close to capturing Yahya Sinwar, who is the leader of Hamas, the terrorist group that has oppressed not only Israel, but oppressed Gaza. For years and years, we've already been praying here. One of our staff members grew up in Gaza, and we've been praying very much that God would mercifully take out this oppressive leadership that is just crushing the people there, using the money that had the billions that had been spent to live in luxury in different places, and at the same time that they're in building the tunnels and all of this, rather than investing into the good of their people. So what we're praying is for the good of Gaza as well as the good of Israel. And what we felt the Lord showed us was, as he had escaped two times just this week, they narrowly escaped, and another mastermind of the October 7th massacres and horrible things that happened, Mohammed Deif, the same, they've tried several times, they've come so close to capturing him. And as we were praying, the Lord reminded me of something he led us to back in 2004. That was the end of 4 years of suicide bombings here in Jerusalem, of terror bombings toward innocent victims. We knew people who were part of the victim, some of the victims. And toward the end of that time, we were crying out to God, Lord, we thank you each time that we see you intervene, but this has to come to an end. And we felt like the Lord spoke to us about occult shields of protection, that people who are demonized terror leaders have an occult shield of protection. It's interesting in Numbers 14, when Joshua and Caleb said, look, we can just go in and take the giants. It's nothing to us. The other people were so afraid because it seemed so impossible. But they said, their protection is gone. And I think they repeated three times in Numbers 14, their protection is gone. God is with us. We will go in and we will slay the giants and we will take what God has promised and not allow them to continue. But of course, God had been very patient for 400 years for the cup of iniquity to be fulfilled, filled up by the Canaanites before God judged the Canaanites. So God reminded us in 2004, there was a main terrorist leader named Sheikh Yassin, who was continually demonically calling the people to continued suicide bombings and these kind of things. And the Lord spoke to us to pray that his occult shield of protection would be taken away, then that God would deal with him however God would deal with him. Of course, we prayed for his repentance first, but that if he did not repent, that he would be somehow removed from this ability to continue to incite the death of so many people. And so we prayed this, and within 2 weeks, he had previously, time after time, the IDF had tried to capture him or take him out. They would miss him by 1 minute, 2 minutes. Within 2 weeks, he was ready to go outside. His aide said to him, don't go outside. I hear a plane overhead. And he said, Allah protects me. I can go anywhere I want to. And he stepped outside and he was taken out in a pinpoint strike with no other people affected by it. And within a very short time, that 4 years of suicide bus bombings had dialed down and stopped. This was the major turning of the tide. So we believe it's a time for the turning of the tide. It's interesting that Friday morning, yesterday morning, was the winter solstice here in Israel, which means it was the longest night That means tonight will be shorter and the next night will be shorter. So we're believing that the darkness of the night of war will become shorter and shorter, and that the light will begin to arise. But very key to this are these two major leaders, Sinwar and Deif, being somehow removed from power. Now, I'm not calling that we pray for them to die. What we're praying is that they repent, first of all. But if they do not repent, that God would remove them from power. We prayed a very similar prayer concerning a leader in Sudan. And we prayed, Lord, would you remove that spider? Let him repent or remove that spider and the spider web, the evil system that he has built in Sudan, which at that time was the number two terrorist state after Iran in the whole Middle East. And I've never had this happen before, but the very next day, in the headlines, it used the exact words of what we proclaimed. The New York Times said that the leader of Sudan had been, al-Bashir, had been, it used these words, the spider has been removed from his spider web. Exactly what the Lord had led us to pray. Now, he was removed without dying. The coup overthrew him. They had tried time after time for over 20 years without success. But the next day, he was removed in a successful coup. And soon after that, a few months after that, Sudan actually normalized relationships, made peace with Israel, and said, we lay down terrorism and putting all of our economy into terror. And now they've been seeking to help the people of their country instead of putting all the money into arms and into terror. So I encourage you to pray together with us now. Father, we agree together from Jerusalem that you are the Lord of heaven and earth. You are Lord God Almighty. You are the Lord God of Israel. You are the Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And we thank you that you not only love this nation and the unique purposes that you have for it, but you love every nation and every people. And so we cry to you, Lord, according to your great mercies for the people that have been oppressed here in Israel, and the people that have been oppressed there in Gaza by the work of this arch-terrorist group, Hamas, that you, O God, will bring about a turning of the tide at this time. We pray together, let their occult shields of protection be taken away from Sinwar, from Deif, from every other voice of incitement to violence, that doesn't really seem to care about what happens to the people of their nation. God, would those voices be silenced? Would their power be silenced? We pray that these spiders will be removed, however you choose to do that, whether it's through repentance or other people rising up and suddenly against them, or they're being captured, or whatever you choose in your great wisdom and your great sovereignty. We pray that these spiders will be permanently removed, that their spider web will be permanently removed, and that there will be a turning of the tide for the redemption of Israel and the redemption of Gaza. In the name of Yeshua, amen.